Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to do an assembly for the tape holder. If I go up here to the top and hit OK, open file, hit assembly and OK. Now, usually when we put in something into the assembly, the first one would be the main body itself, the biggest thing. Now, if I click there, you'll see very important down here is this fully defined, there's marks going for this. So that is locked in space now, it can't go up or down, left or right, forwards or backwards. So when that's in, you go over there and you put in your next part, and put in the cutter. Now, this is actually back to front of the cutter, so if I go up here to move components, I can pick on rotate, hold down my left mouse button and spin it around. And now I'm going to go in and I'm going to mate it. So it usually takes 3 mates to mate an object and get it fully defined. And I only put in one object at a time and make sure it's fully defined before I put in another one. So it slides over there, hit OK. Now the next thing I want to mate there is that face there. And I'll zoom in here carefully. I want to touch on this face down here. Hit OK. And the last thing there is to mate that there, the top here, and slot down. That guy is perfectly in place now and it's fully defined. So now, only now because it's fully defined, will I go and put in another part. So the last part I'm going to put in here in this one is the spinner. So I'm going to hit open and pop it in there. Now it's underdefined again because this is all locked in space. If I hold it down and drag the left mouse button, I can't move it. This guy I can move all over the place. Now let's start mating them in place. So I select this face here. I'm going to want to touch on this. So that has lined it up there, you can see now. So I hit OK. Now I can, you could set planes there and get it in place as well. For this demo though, I'm going to show you putting in a tangential mate. So I want that circular object, or cylindrical object, in contact with this face here. And that has lined it up there, so I hit OK. And another mate then I could have would be this guy again, tangential with this face. Now, that is it down there. So if I try and move it now, I can't. I can spin it alright, but I can't drag it out of there, but it's underdefined. So you could, if you wanted to go in and do one last mate, it usually takes 3, in that case because you have something that could be, would be spinning in reality, it may take 4. So I could, if I wanted to there, open the spinner design tree and select the top plane, and on the main body as well, I could select the top plane there, and that would spin, lock them in place. You can see it moving in there. I'm just going to undo that. By the way, actually, you can go down here at any time and check all the mates you have. So I'm going to do a mate here just to show you something different. If you want to, you could do an advanced mate, which is called a mechanical mate. And we could pick the top plane on the main body and the top plane on the spinner there. Before I select it there, I just hit this angle, select the top plane. And I can turn, if I turn this guy up to 359, it'll set it that the spinner will be able to move within the body. So I'll hit OK there. And now you'll see it has changed to fully defined. But I can still spin it. Now it doesn't matter if it doesn't spin, you can just mate the two planes and have them parallel, locked in place. You get full marks there as well. You don't get any extra marks for having them moving. But I just thought I'd show you something different. So that is the tape holder assembled. Thank you.